So here are my takeaways from building the FarmerTech or Pulseforma MS660. This one now has about, 8 hours of runtime on it. I've kept it pretty well tuned, and I've been running steel 50-to-1 ratio fuel in it. I really only do that for convenience, and I am obviously not a professional. I've never built one of these saws before. This is my first one. There's a couple of takeaways from it. One is everything needs Loctite. This muffler came loose, and when it came loose, it wasted the gasket, and somehow we're missing a screw. And I don't know where that went. It must have come out of the muffler somehow, but I guess out of the exhaust port. I haven't the foggiest where it went. We need to get that dealt with. But it's a good saw. It rips. I've got a 25 inch bar on it. I've been running a 36 inch bar on it for milling. It has plenty of power for that. I think my couple of takeaways really from the build are Loctite on absolutely everything, even stuff like this right here. You can see this bucking spike is loose. I didn't assemble that came from the factory. They're going to have to be Loctited. The other thing is that on this mechanism right here, for the operator presence lever and the trigger, is really, that took a lot of filing and finicking and messing around. And if I had it to do over again, I just would have ordered an OEM one. Also, this handle for the on-off stop high idle choke lever is kind of a joke. It's real flimsy. You need to have I would recommend buying an OEM one. The other one, and this is not me, I didn't like the Husqvarna, or the, I'm sorry, the decompression valve that came with it. So I got a Husqvarna decompression valve, partially because the one that came with it, they're apparently known to be real unreliable, and you don't want that going through your engine. Anyway, so far it works great. I need to put this muffler back together. I need to get a new gasket for it, but that's definitely not the end of the world. And it's a hell of a lot less money than buying a 661 or a 660 or whatever. I think if I was going to do it again on this saw, what I told you would be the additions that I would make. And then the other thing, I've done a couple of other things. I'm kind of tempted to run a pressure vacuum test on this while I've got it apart. But I did use some gasket sealer here, even though steel says not to. I just felt like I needed to. I did check the squish. I did port the piston, and I did advance the timing. The timing advance, I actually wound up putting it back to stock. I filed out the flywheel to about 5 degrees or something. And sorry, that's my kid making noise in the background. It makes it really a bugger to start. And this thing is I think it's a 91 cc saw. It's already kind of a lot to start. So I actually bought an OEM flywheel and put it on there too. I would not do that again. I think if I was running like a performance deal, I think I would, but, it's just unnecessary and it makes it hard to start. So anyway, that's my 2 cents from a non-pro, first build. I hope everybody has a good day.